Example 6. So in this example 6, they have given a right angle, a triangle ABC, right angle at B, this angle is 90 degree, and AB is equal to 5 cm, this length is given 5 cm, and ACB, that is 30 degree acute angle, this is 90 degree, this is another acute angle. Determine the lengths of the sides BC and AC. So BC and AC, we have to find out. See, they have given one side and one angle. Using this, you have to find out the remaining two sides. How to find? You have to use the trigonometric ratios now. So you want to find out this hypotenuse, you can use this. Opposite, this is opposite side to this acute angle. AB is the opposite side to the acute angle. So therefore, you can use this sine 30 degree. Sine 30 degree, you know, opposite side is AB. So hypotenuse here AC. What is sine 30? You have to remember that ratios. Suppose if I write this a triangle, so this is 60 degree, this is 30 degree, and this is 90. I told you to remember this one, 1, 2, root 3. You remember this one. So we want sine 30. Sine 30 means, look at the diagram and tell me, sine 30, opposite side by hypotenuse, 1 by 2. So in place of sine 30, you can write 1 by 2 is equal to AB by AC. Substitute the value AB here. So 1 by 2 is equal to AB here 5 by AC. So it gives you, so AC into 1, AC into 1 is AC, 5 into 2 is 10 units, 10 centimeter. So you got this as 10 centimeter. So we got the length, AC is equal to 10 centimeter. Similarly, we want to find out the BC. BC can be calculated, look at this, adjacent side by hypotenuse, cos 30 you will take. Cos 30, we have adjacent side BC, hypotenuse here AC, with reference to this diagram, adjacent side by hypotenuse. And to find out the ratios, you know that, remember this one, 1, 2, root 3, this is 30 degree, we want cos 30, cos 30 means adjacent side by hypotenuse, root 3 by 2. So here you can write root 3 by 2. Here, whatever the values you know, BC we want to calculate. AC already calculated, you can substitute that one. BC by AC here 10. We already found out that AC length. So now simplify this one. So 2 times BC is equal to 2 into BC is equal to root 3 into 10. So BC is equal to, so 10 root 3 by 2. So if you simplify this one, BC is equal to 5 root 3 centimeter. So this is the length of side BC. So we got the all the three sides of this triangle. So initially it was given only one side and one acute angle. So we found out the other two sides. So in trigonometry, if you are able to form, see, if you get a one side and one acute angle, then any side can be calculated in the triangle. So this is how you can do this one. In triangle PQ, right angle at Q, this angle is 90 degree. PQ is equal to 3 cm, PR is equal to 6 cm. PQ is 3 and PR is 6 cm. Determine angle QPR, this acute angle. We need to find out this acute angle, another PR, another acute angle. Both the acute angles you have to identify. We need to find the angles here. How to find these angles? Only the two sides are given, you can find out the ratios. You can find out the ratio. What are the sides given? PQ and PR. So you find out this PQ by PR. PQ by PR. It is same as, see, PQ. It is an opposite side of this angle R. So this is, with reference to this angle R, this is opposite side. And this is hypotenuse. Opposite side by hypotenuse. PQ by PR is nothing but opposite side by hypotenuse to, with reference to this angle R. So what you can write, opposite side by hypotenuse, it is nothing but sine of this acute angle R. Sine R is PQ by PR. So now sine R is PQ value, you know that it is 3, PR value it is 6. So sine R, so we'll go to the next page. So sine R is 1 by 2. So 1 by 2, where you will get it opposite? Sine R, you can draw this diagram. So 1, 2, root 3, to remember this trigonometric ratios. 1 by 2, it is sine r means opposite side by hypotenuse. 1 should be the opposite side. The numerator should be opposite. Because sine r means it is nothing but opposite side by hypotenuse. So opposite by hypotenuse should be 1 by 2. So which will be the opposite side to this? 1 should be the opposite side. 1 will be opposite side. This should be opposite side. And this must be hypotenuse. See, look at this. 1 by 2. It is nothing but sine 30 degree. So it is possible only for sine 30 degree. So sine 30 degree will be equal to 1 by 2. So that means in place of r you can write angle r is equal to 30 degree. So you got the value of r. So sine r, this is 30 degree. Okay. Similarly, you can find out this also, other P angle also. See, once it is known, this is 90 degree, this is 30 degree, you can write directly, angle P must be equal to 60 degree. Angle sum property. Otherwise, you want to use trigonometric ratio only. See, this with reference to angle P, you can write cos P is nothing but adjacent side by hypotenuse. PQ by PR. Cos P, it is nothing but 3 by 6. Cos P, it is 1 by 2. So cos P 1 by 2. How you will get? 1 should be the adjacent side by hypotenuse. Cos means adjacent by hypotenuse. That means 1 should become the adjacent side. Adjacent side means for this angle. So 60 degree. So cos 60 is 1 by 2. So that means angle P is equal to 1 by 2. So you can find like this the angles also. Here, see what is the difference between the previous question and this question. In the previous question, one angle and one side was given. In this question, two sides were given. So you can find out the other two angles of this triangle. Acute angles can be identified using the trigonometric ratios.